very much, Senator Niall O'Donnell.
Leader, I noted with interest some of the remarks from Senator Feehan, and I wouldn't disagree with what Senator Feehan proposed or suggested at all in relation to a role that the Irish government can play in supporting and helping develop other peace processes around the world. But I would contest that they should probably focus a bit more of their attention on the peace process of our own, our Indigenous peace process, and the outstanding commitments, like a public inquiry into the murder of Pat Finucane, like the introduction of a Human Rights Act, like the introduction of an Irish Language Act, before they start to focus on processes elsewhere. Leader, RTE's reporting this morning, I think actually quite good news, that the Department of Foreign Affairs have employed an additional 230 staff in the passport office. This is probably the only example where Brexit is creating jobs on this island, as opposed to doing damage to our jobs. But the figures for me, Leader, were quite stark and quite impressive. And I wanted to commend the staff in the passport office, who it's clear have been dealing with a huge amount of additional work as a result of this. So if you look at some of the figures from Britain, there was a 74% increase in passport applications from January last year. In the north, there was 7,000 people in January alone who applied for passports. That's a huge percentage increase in January of last year. In Britain, there was a jump of 71% in January this year compared to last year. So overall, 2016, there were 67,972 passport applications from the north, while there was 64,996 passport applications from Britain as well. We have talked about Brexit and the huge economic and political and social implications thereof numerous times already, Leader, and I have no doubt and I hope that the Minister for Foreign Affairs and indeed the Taoiseach will come back before us soon and indeed regularly to talk about that with senators. But I think this allows for a very practical debate, Leader, with the Minister for Foreign Affairs to talk about the issue of citizenship post-Brexit, what Irish citizenship will look like, what it will mean and what it will do for people, particularly people in the north who want to avail of their Irish and therefore their EU citizenship. So, Les Cathaoirleach, I'll finish on this. This is probably an example, Leader, of where the government, I think, could actually take quite a positive unilateral initiative to open a passport office in the north, which wouldn't just be symbolic for Irish citizens there. These figures actually indicate that it would be a very, very practical, strategic advantage for them to do that. So that's maybe some, Leader, that you'll consider us discussing, but also raising with the Minister.
Thank you, Senator. Senator